Lectavation back at it again. Thanks for stopping in, folks. Good evening, good morning, good night, whatever part of the world you're from. Ready to go full throttle. The last review was episode 3 of my completion of the Airport Complete Set XL from Harper. So I'm ready to go all in with all my models. What I'll be doing is right before I shoot a video on the channel, I'm going to display the pieces that's going to be in the latest update slash video, whatever you want to call it. As I stated in the completion video of the airport setup, I have a dedicated terminal. By the way, you have terminal A, B, C, and D. Let me correct. Before I just said you had A, B, and C. Well, you know what? Let's keep it as A, B, and C. Three structures, terminal A, B, and C. But terminal C is dedicated just to American Airlines. That'll be my dominant carrier at my airport. Not to mention, I have more pieces. My biggest carrier and livery in my collection is Delta. Delta International Airlines. But I love American Airlines. You know why, if you've been paying attention and following up on my reviews. Anyway, let's get started. And mind you, most of my collection, most of my pieces, I bought them, never opened the box, or just left them, just been stacking. So some things I have that I'm aware of, some things I have no clue that I have. But I know I have a lot of American pieces. I'm excited. So let's get this stuff unboxed. Got pieces from 27s, 200s. Got two of those. Let's get this all laid out. Well, you know what? This is open already. All right. So let's put this to the side here. And let's get that real feeling of opening up. Actual unboxing. So this piece here, this package I should say, it's all American Airlines for my collection. I don't recall what I have in here. This has been in my possession for about 3 years. So let's get this up and open. See what we got here. American Airlines. Oh, la la. All right. I'm going to get these all out and we'll be right back with you, folks. All right, we got box number one unboxed. And just keep in mind, remember, we have this one. So I'm going to get this out the way here. All right. So it looks like American Airlines Dragon Wings. This is the first ever fly-by-wire aircraft in world history, made by Airbus. A330 Dragon Wings. This piece is probably almost 25, 30 years old. 20 years old, give or take. Let's keep it as that. Great condition. Anyway, American Airlines A330. Got another American Airlines, and this is by Dragon Wings. Another American Airlines A330, A300. Look at this piece, the Boeing 747 SP. This is a long range carrier here. And the beautiful thing about this piece here, this craft, I should say, is this, it gives you the same outlook of a 47, but because of its shorter length span, it's able to go a little bit further than the average 47. In actuality, the range on this piece is, this craft is 7,658 miles. It's amazing. She was running Pratt & Whitney. Most of these been configured, if not retired, to private pieces throughout the world. So we got this piece. I'm gonna save the best for last. Anyway, 378 American Airlines. All right. Another 378 American Airlines. Gemini Jets. And in the comments, let me know what you want me to do reviews on. But most of these pieces will always be on the tarmac at the airport. And again, if you don't know, I'm here last time. This airport is non-fictional. And the name of this airport, I designated to be Lex International Airport. Look at this amazing piece. Look at this. Look at the contrast. Look at the chrome. That's what I love about American Airlines. Doesn't matter where you go. If you're an aviationist as a kid, or just aviation in general, you always look forward to seeing that silver bird, no matter what piece it was, whether it was a 27 or DC-9. But American Airlines stood out because of their silver chrome look. When you had a perfect day and that sun ambiance glowing, it was amazing. But look at this piece here. Thank you to the seller. I can't remember who this was, to keep it in such a great condition. And a lot of people, you know, these are not just toys. These are not toys. These are collectible, cherishable items. So a lot of people have them out just sitting there. And if you don't have the right temperature, the right atmosphere, it gets tarnished. But this person probably bought this and never took it out and chose to sell it. And I reap the rewards. But look at this 67300. Amazing. Without the winglets. We got a MD-82, MagDog 82, / DC-982, but it's really a MD-82 before DC bought them. I'm sorry, before MD bought them. Look at that. American Airlines. And we look at a 738 Harper. All American workhorse. They don't make them like this anymore, folks. MD-11, and this is by Aero Classics, DC-10. Now this is a 67300ER with the winglets, extended range. So, 67 regular, 673R, I'm sorry, ER. Should be doing a review on this. Anyway, you comment. You let me know what you want to see your review on. The best for last. Now, I love this piece. And this is a... If you guys are real collectors, not saying you're not, don't take it as an insult. But this is a very rare piece to find and get. Not only that, if you can't get it, the price is bonkers. This is undisclosed how much I paid for it, but this was hard to get. A 777-3... ER in American Airlines original colors is very hard to get. Very, very hard. But I got it and I'm proud. You'll see her soon. And here's a 777-2. Look at that. Look at that beauty. Alright. Alright, let's go to box number 2. Actually, I'm sorry, folks. I have some more pieces over here. I didn't even realize. Boeing 572. Nice piece here. This was a piece that was very hard to get in the One World colors. Got it. Bid on this for about at least 5-6 days. I think I paid too much for it, but hey, I got it. Got the only one in my collection. I'm proud of it. You'll see what I'm talking about when I take her out. Nickname Long Legs. 5'7". Well, the nickname is Long Legs because if you're a dead center in front of her or from the side, the front gear structure is long. Or the ambiance appears to be longer than the average craft. That's why they nicknamed them long legs. Another 572 with the winglets. All right. We got a 672. I'm sorry, a 272. This was one of my favorite aircrafts when I was a younger kid. A lot of people don't know this today. Most of these crafts, you had three crew members in the front. That's what we call it. Most people know it as a cockpit pilots, but you had three in the front. You had a co-pilot, captain, you had a first officer, a captain, and a flight engineer, which was an unofficial pilot. Because most aircrafts, before fly-by-wire, you needed, once the pilot took off and the, I'm sorry, once the, yeah, pilot, captain, first officer, he or she, they turned over above, once they got a positive rate of climb, turned the AP on. Or before they turned AP on, depending on most pilots we flew back then, you turned the craft over to the flight engineer, which was number three. 27 was one of the crafts left and still operational throughout America, and if not the world, that had a three operational crew. Again, let me know what craft you want me to see do reviews on. Another 672. I'm sorry, 27. 7272. I speak aviation term, pilot term. We don't say 727-200. We say 722. You know what that means. That's 722 coming. Delta 952, hold short of the 722. Hold short of the 72. Anyway. Moving on, TWIA, which later on American Airlines bought them, which is a Boeing 717. In my mind, it's a DC-9, but we'll call it for what it is. In actuality, it is a DC-9 because Boeing acquired Douglas Corporation, just like the Mad Dogs, which was same thing. Douglas Corporation. McDonnell Douglas. But you had Boeing, McDonnell Douglas, and the Douglas Corporation. MD-82. Beautiful piece. I love these pieces. Alright. We're winding down to the last six pieces. 673ER. New colors. 378. Oh, look at this baby. Anyway, we'll say it to A320 American Airlines new colors. It's actually a Neo. Looking at the power plants. 333. New colors. Gemini Jets. Oops. Boeing 378. Mountaineer. Limited edition. And last but not least, the best for last, folks. We got a DC-10. This is one of my favorite pieces by American that I have in my collection. DC-10, American Airlines, original colors. All right, again, let me know what you want me to do a review on. I'm sorry, last but not least, but I decided to add this to my collection because Virgin America, which is now American Airlines, acquired that, their fleet on the American side. I decided to add it to it. All right, that concludes my pre-review before I set up my American carrier. Again, Terminal B will be dedicated just for American Airlines. You may see some layovers, some carriers that's renting out slot spaces and time. But this particular terminal, which is B, will always be American Airlines. You got four heavies, slots, and two regulars. Like, comment, subscribe, folks. Let me know again. And one more thing. I don't know. People don't like me so far, I guess. Nobody likes, nobody subscribes. Give me some comments. Let me know, what do you want me to say? You want me to shut up? I'm talking too much? Whatever. I'm trying. I'm new to this. But mind you, I got a lot of pieces in my collection. All right? So if you're a real collector and aviationist, you want to stay tuned to me. But I can only know what you guys want to hear from me from what you don't want to hear. If you comment, like, and subscribe. Nobody let me know. This is the only structure left in my airport that I didn't put up yet. I could just say screw it and do it. But I want you guys to let me know. What do you want to see? The chrome fuel tanks or the white ones? They're all six pieces. It's the only section left. Let me know, folks. The chrome pieces or the white ones? If not, it is what it is. Thanks for tuning in. Like, comment, subscribe. Like, Aviation out.